Hello, my name is Anthony Ariano, and I'm doing my TED Talk style report on the director Nicholas Winding Refn, known for films like Drive, Valhalla Rising, and Neon Demon. I chose Refn not just because of his unique style, but because he is colorblind like myself. A common misconception is that people who are colorblind can only see black and white. In reality, colorblindness is the decreased ability to see color or the differences in color. Approximately 1 in 12 men and 1 in 200 women are affected. There are four different types of colorblindness, and although total colorblindness is one of them, it is the rarest, affecting only 0.00003% of the world's population. The other three types are tritanopia, protanopia, and the most common, deuteranopia. The purpose of this report isn't to explain colorblindness, but I wanted to give you a better understanding on what people like Refn and myself see when we are watching films, and how he's created his own unique and personalized style despite it.
I've only really known one woman, and I was out buying her a pair of shoes, and she kept on trying the same two pairs on. And I was like, what is wrong with her? Can't she not see that it's the same pair of shoes? And my wife says, oh my God, you're colorblind. I wanted to show to everyone else that having any kind of handicap can also be a blessing. And anything that's normal is so fucking uninteresting. I was struggling in the beginning because I was making movies more based on how I would like to be perceived. I thought I was born to be the greatest filmmaker of all time, and I sadly realized I wasn't. But then I decided on something else, that with the films I made, I was going to be the best at. The only rule of the game is make sure it makes money.
Refn has three major components to his film style. His use of color to create a forbidding atmosphere, total viewer immersion through iconography, and brutal, shocking violence. The first component is the most important in the context of this report, how Refn uses heavily contrasted colors, due to his color vision, to create a jarring and uninviting atmosphere. In films like The Neon Demon and Only God Forgives, Refn uses very bright neon tones that stand out against harsh backgrounds to give off a shady nightclub vibe, while creating an uncomfortable and surreal atmosphere. The atmosphere he creates with his color is the backbone of his style. He uses his color to represent the polarity of life. Where there is heaven, there is hell. Where there is joy, there is aggression. One of his more subtle examples is in the movie Drive. The protagonist is almost always in blue, whether it be his wardrobe, background, or color scheme they chose in post. Irene is constantly shown in red or dark orange. Refn is trying to show her world is warm and loving while his is cold and unforgiving. As Irene's life starts to fall apart around her, she remains oblivious. Refn portrays this by slowly making her surroundings more blue, while she remains in warm colors, until she finally sees the driver stomp out the guy in the elevator. It's the first time she really sees him for who he is. She's no longer naive to her surroundings, and it's the first time we see her in a completely blue shot. The second and third components of his film are relying on the first, but still very important by themselves. Refn's characters have very little dialogue because it helps build that uncomfortable feeling that his colors generate. More importantly, he uses iconography or creating simpler characters rather than more complex ones to make it easier for the viewer to identify with the character and become better immersed into the film on a deeper level.
Violence is like sex. It's all about the build-up.
Did you get that?
His third component is using brutal, shocking violence that usually comes out of nowhere or after a lot of tension builds up. And when it hits hard. Refn likes to fetishize his violence, and the potency of such is completely dependent on the buildup. The colors create an uninviting atmosphere. The silent protagonist helps insert the viewer into that atmosphere. And the violence strikes at the climax of tension while hitting the viewer like a freight train. I wouldn't say Refn is my favorite director. I really did not care for Neon Demon at all, but I certainly have a very high respect for him, knowing what he's accomplished despite his handicap that we both share.